Got this abandoned caravan with no chest in it, that's fine. And then the old bridge. Bunch of lads we can nobble for no clear reason. None of them drops any cool headgear, because of course they didn't. Maybe we'll explore one side of the highway into Leyendal. There's got to be something interesting either to the left or right of it, I feel. Oh, I was kind of hoping to sneak up on this lad, but I guess he's not having any of that. Ouch. Because this guy's got cool armor. Ouch. We both went for a charge attack and his was better. If I can keep blocking his attacks and going for the old guard counters, that's cool. And down he goes. And we didn't get any armor piece. But we could probably farm that guy for armor, were we so inclined. But for now, let's explore the left-hand side of this highway. And once again, I've forgotten to check if I've got any more flasks. I'm pretty sure I have, to be honest. We'll start up here. Is this leading to a cave? Or anything exciting? Bunch of messages. And on the map it looks like it's probably leading to a cave. Or a catacomb or something. Amber starlight. That's new. Not much else going on around here though, except for a bunch of crafting materials by the look of it. What's the statue of? A woman hugging her child, or something along those lines. Fair enough. It's probably rich with lore significance. Let's see what's up this way. The first answer is a bunch of dudes. Yikes. Now slightly fewer dudes. Hmm. Real observant there, my friend. And bears. Small bears, but still bears. Is that a bigger bear? Looks like it might be a rune bear of some sort, but might just be another bear, another regular bear. Either way, we'll probably not tussle with it if we don't need to. Now, poison? Are you just gonna spew out poison forever? Oh, there's a cave. Cool. Humor's Grotto. That sounds like a fun place to hang out. Flasks. We still haven't got enough golden seeds. What? I was sure we had. But we have got enough rune for a level up. We need more vigor because we're just dying all the time. Well, that looks like, yeah, it's an enemy. There's another one. Are they all perfumers? Maybe. Yep, that was perfume. And whap-ow! There'll be no chucking of pots from you, my friend. So we've got a cool looking flower down there. Looks a bit different to the rest. And we're poisoned. So now let's just get in there and wreck it up. Because what's it going to do to us that it hasn't already? That was supposed to be a crit, but hey-ho. This poison seems to be wearing off pretty quick, so that's nice. Right, you're coming up for a scrap by the look. Chose the wrong time to step up there, my friend. And yeah, there's the poison again. And there's the crit this time, good. I mean, it wasn't huge extra damage, but that's fine. There's the womp. That's what I was worried about. Chest, you say? Multiple chests. More living jar shards, fine. Is this one going to be like a ritual pot or something? Perfume bottle, same sort of thing, but for perfumes. Now, what are you doing here? I wonder if I should be using magic against you, because, yeah. Yeah, I thought as much. Ow. Yay. It's dead. We need never speak of it again. Hopefully. And an arterial leaf for our troubles. Ah, this is related to Walter's tunnels then. That was the lad who was throwing rocks down it. Where's his head before, I think. And now that he's out of the way, maybe if we go in the tunnels for Trace later, we won't have an issue. Bit of Miranda powder's all well and good. Looks like we've got a boss fight with no Steak America nearby. Just what we wanted, basically. And let's drink a potion because we want to bring in Lutal, probably. Even though they were useless in the last fight. Oh, darn. It's 2-on-1. So let's make it 2-on-2. Oh, fuck off. Hit like a truck. Triss has not had a good time of it today, I'll tell you that. Now, is there any good reason for these two to be just sat in a cave together? Does it make any sense to anyone? All I know is my gut says probably not, no. Happily, that big bugger hasn't respawned. Now, these lads, though. Run them out of the way, otherwise Luce will probably try and go for them through the fog door like an absolute goon. We've got so many summons. And we've not leveled up any of the rest of them by the look of it. Oh, when did we get Miranda sprouts? They cost HP to summon. It's kind of cool. Right, come on, Lucille. Do some work for me. Oh, fuck you. I'm just trying to get my runes back. Now, let's go deal with this lad if we can. We're going to get poisoned, yep. Not a lot we can do about that. What hit us? Was that Omen Killer? Hitting us through the flower. Ah, didn't have any time there to get a crit. Right, good. Now, shall we fling some spells out? Well, piss off with your triple strikes. Go on, Luce, we'll do some work. There we go. Finally. Great Omen Killer Cleaver. Good job, you headless knobhead. And so we did all that for, what? A fistful of runes and a sword we're not going to use? That's a great axe. Of course it is. Pretty cool, I guess. But not for us. Still, we did what I wanted to do. We had a little adventure and we got a win. Let's just go make sure we haven't got any potential upgrades we can do with good old Master Hugh. Oh yeah, got a bunch of smithing stones to upgrade our shield at least. And shall we upgrade our staff anymore? Why not? We can afford ones and twos, no trouble. Even buy another couple of ones, assuming we've got the right bell bearing for it.
Greetings.
And let's see what we can do with Roderica.
I feel like I'm really coming to grips with spirit tuning of late. I can see how and why immortal essence exists, a spirit under the golden order. I can understand their yearnings, what they become drawn to. Master Hugh said it himself, actually. That I'm no mere prentice any longer. Once again, I'm pleased to make your acquaintance. Roderica, the Certified Spirit Tuner.
Good for you, Roddy. I'm glad to hear that things are working out for you. Now, would you mind, if you could be so good, as to upgrade my rats? Ooh. Four giant rat spirits, you say? Nice. Should we upgrade anything else? Let's see. We've got Lucille for single combat. We've got rats for multi-combat. We haven't got marionette archers yet. I guess we just raced through the academy. Or did we even visit the academy? That's a question. Yeah, we have. And we must have raced through. But we've also got a curtsy. Lovely. Let's try it out. Grand. Have we been? It looks like we haven't been to see the Blackguard yet. So we should probably go to the Boiled Prawn Shack because Yeah, we've got the runes on us. Although, is Deathbird going to be hanging around? Well, there's a problem if Deathbird's hanging around, because we can always get it to bugger off, can't we? By just dying to it. Sup, Prawn Boy? Let me just check. Is it night time? Yes. Shall we go on a Deathbird hunt? Why not? There we go. Go on then, Deathbird. Where are you? Oops. Ah, that wasn't so bad. But if it is going to keep hitting us, then that's not great. Ouch. Headshots are the way forward, probably. Maybe I should be timing my spells better. Yep. There we go. Jobs are good. Trinket we don't need, and a good chunk of rune. Bit more intelligence, why not? Praise the prawn. Yeah.
What are you looking, trying to start?
Cool. See you later, my blackguard friend. Now, where's friend Raya? We'll have a chat with her and then we'll go and deal with that dick Rennala if we can. Hello, Raya.
The thug should be please. Oh yes, thank you, kind. Did I forget? I am. I seek. You are very but to steady heart. Such please. Brave Tarnos tarnished. But you are no the volcano manor.
See you later, Raya. Right, now much as I hate this stupid dick Rennala, we do need to beat her because we're going to probably get both of her remembrance things, the staff and the spell. Oh yeah, I can't use my horse in here. Why am I even trying? But we're going to want to rely on sword play in the first phase of the fight. Because we don't want to use up all our FP before we face her directly. Then we'll probably lob a bunch of rock slings in her face. Please. Now, how do you feel about getting stabbed? Two stabs will do it. You just bite my ankles, you little shit. There we go. Right, where is she? Bollocks, I rolled away from that. Piss. Yeah, we haven't got the flasks for this, have we? Because we need the FP. Now we need to just get out of the way of the tombstones. I like the way those little pillars will get the job done. Fucking stop hiding behind one another, you little shit. Why can't I lock on to the right targets? And she's down again. Good. Got her. Just about. Good. And now what? Her. Go. See how she feels about rocks in her face. She doesn't seem to like them. Good. Ah, bollocks. Bollocks, bollocks, bollocks. Ah, fuck off, you bitch. Fucking double homing bullshit in a row. It's just too much to focus on having to switch between flasks and all that bollocks. Maybe I'm better off putting my other flasks on my pouch.
Better off getting good.
Fuck you, buddy. Fucking Bobby do nothing with his smart ass comments. He's probably right though. That's the worst bit. But yeah, it's just a massive pain in the ass when you're trying to dodge like three different spells at once, and also focus on switching between your bars, and focus on switching between your weapons. This is why I tend to stick to just physical or just magic with most of my characters. Or at least I did before Elden Ring. Because just the UI is not designed to fucking switch back and forth between weapons and all that bollocks. Right. Roll. 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 Good. Flask. Good. Oops, send to me. So that's that spell cast wasted. Now those coming to me? Yeah. Fuck you! That was going really well, and then she's just like, she does the homing shot into the comet, and it just fucks you. But yeah, I was liking the flask switch though. Moving the flask onto the pouch was actually pretty good. Because red flask is the one that you just need in a pinch. So being able to get to it with just one button press is great. Blue flask is generally a little less crucial. So having to hold down an extra button to do it, not the end of the world. And now... Nice. Quick sup. Safety flask. Engvall's doing a great job of stun locking her. Well, we both are, really. Ah, jeez. And she's practically dead. Nice. She didn't even summon anything. It's like, is that because I didn't ever get close to her? Or what? It's a mystery to me. But we will definitely take that.
Where did he flee, my sweetheart?
Shut up, woman.
Thou is it thy to become.
Go away. Never speak to me again. Right, where do we want the levels? We still need more vigor, obviously. More mind would be nice. Now, we could also use a mausoleum. Have we already used the one in the Weeping Peninsula? Maybe. I feel like we probably did. We certainly took it out. Just to shut the bloody thing up. We didn't use it, so we can duplicate the Full Moon Queen. And that means we can get ourselves two presents. Let's see if Enya's got anything to say about us having three great runes. No, she doesn't care. Fine. So we'll grab ourselves a Carrion Regal Scepter. And we'll grab ourselves a spell. Neither of which we'll be able to use for a long time. But that's fine. Yes, we will listen to these giant, decaying, hairy fingers. Or maybe we'll just keep pootling around like a mad thing.